BCTN was going on all game long.
Good morning, Bears, and welcome to our St. Patrick's Day edition. I'm here with a very special Bear Creek grad, Jeremiah Sirles.
Let's go. Bounce to the beat, people hands up. Everybody in the place, stand up. And jump and shake and rush the club. Till the whole entire building is rammed up. And there's nothing you can do to hold them off. And while the beautiful women be showing off, we about to cause a riot in this bitch. Till we hearing the fire alarms going off.
Got them watching. We really got them on a trance.
Hey guys, my name is Jeremiah Sirles. I graduated here in 2009, where then I went and attended the University of Nebraska. And then I finished there in 2013. And I went to the San Diego Chargers, and I'm now current Minnesota Viking, just finished my third year, heading into my fourth year.
Awesome. So we don't have any announcements today, so we're just going to do a quick interview.
Ooh,
so,
works for me.
Mr. Sirles, can you please tell us your favorite high school memory?
Well, my favorite high school memory is probably twofold. My first one is closing night of West Side Story my senior year in the theater. That was a great time. And then a rough memory but a great memory was when we lost my senior year in the playoffs to Cherry Creek. It was my last time playing with a bunch of those guys who I'm still friends with to this day, and it was a tough memory, but it's still a great memory that I'll always remember when we played Cherry Creek in the semifinals, I believe it was.
Yeah, you heard right. He was a thespian. All right. What advice do you have to all current Bear Creek Bears?
The best advice I could give these guys is to always make sure that even when you're a freshman to when you're a senior, that you apply yourself here. Because it's very easy once you get out of high school to be lost in the world. But if you really apply yourself through high school and with your teachers and with the people who are here to support you, it'll give you a good balance and it'll give you a good foundation for when you move out of this place into the real world. And it only continue to go from there. I mean, I do wish that there was times I spent more attention in class and more times in the classroom with these teachers. But if I can look back on and tell you guys to do that, I think I can help you.
Awesome. Cool. Now for the good stuff. I want a locker room secret. Give us a really nice NFL locker room secret.
A good, nice NFL locker room secret.
We want the dirt.
I guess the biggest one is guys are a lot different than you see them on the field. So you see the guys on the field and you think everyone's this tough guy and these mean guys, and then you'll meet them off the field. For example, Sam Bradford. One of the nicest guys you will ever meet in your entire life. Philip Rivers, so I'm sure, I mean, Bronco Nation here, I know. Philip Rivers, everyone hates Philip Rivers. Everyone thinks that he's just cussing and yelling, but he never says a curse word, not once. It's dadgummit, or dadgum, or sabo, or just something Southern.
Hmm.
And he's got 9 kids from the same woman. Hey,
having kids and
being married and having kids in the NFL, very different questions.
Yes, that's true. So who is the nicest NFL player you've either played for or against?
The nicest guy that I've met and actually talked to is probably going to have to be Terrence Newman. He's 38 years old, going into year 16, I believe. And he played for the Bengals, he played for the Cowboys, he's now on the Vikings, and he's just a guy that you can go and you can talk to. He's a guy that you can really just ask about life in the NFL and life out of the NFL, and he'll be straight up honest with you. And he's just a super good, genuine guy that's done it the right way for a lot of years.
Hmm. Meanest?
Meanest guy.
Who's the biggest jerk in the NFL?
Well, that differs. So for me, it's either Clay Matthews or Mike Daniels, mostly because Packers, Vikings, they don't...
Sure.
They don't necessarily get along all the time, but yeah, it definitely have to be Mike Daniels or Clay Matthews. They never stop talking when you play.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of just poop talking.
Yes, of course. let's ask a question. What's your favorite musical?
Favorite musical, definitely West Side Story.
Or Shrek.
Shrek was a great one. Shrek was a great one.
Shrek the musical.
It helped distract me when I was training for Pro Day. You need a little distraction in your life.
Question from Mr. Martinez. Do you remember anything you learned in econ?
Absolutely. So we had a rap that we had to make on fiscal policy. It was myself, Bo Butler, and Chris Whittles, I believe.
Oh my gosh.
And we worked tirelessly to drop the fire album of 2009. And I'm sure Mr. Martinez still has it if you go and ask him.
We're going to try to find that.
Oh, we'll find it.
Yeah. All right, Bears, that does it for a very special edition of BCTN with our wonderful guest, Mr. Jeremiah Sirles. But before we go, he has something he would like to present to the school.
So because Bear Creek will always be home for me, it's where I started my football career, and it's hopefully where I'll be able to always come back home and call home. I'm giving you guys our Capital One Bowl jersey that we played against Georgia in 2012, I believe. And I want you guys to have it here. I don't really know what you guys want to do with it, but it'll be hung up in the school somewhere to always remember that I was here and that I want to be able to come back here and call this place home. So thank you guys so much for allowing me to come back whenever I please, and I hope to see you all soon.
Thanks, Bears. Awesome. I'm going to wear it.
You can wear it. It's a little tight.
You calling
on me?
That?
No, it's a little tight on me.
We'll see you later.
Bye, guys.
Mr. Wiggles, Mrs. Wiggles, Wiggles, you Republican.
And Katie.
Government, keep supply running. Monetary policy is stunning. Feds be regulating all the skrilla. Interest, income, and stuff even iller. We're gonna take our money to the bank. Shorty, what you think? Shorty, what you think?